اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وانعم وعظم وكرم على سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا وشفيعنا وقائدنا وقرة عيوننا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله that Allah made us to reach this, the last 10 nights of Ramadan, and we are in the odd nights, and you know, this is a time where we need to gain to get the maximum of Laylatul Qadr. It might be tonight. So the smart one who will actually try to make it for the five nights, for sure he will be able to qadr, inshallah. Yeah. And this is something you have to know, that this Laylatul Qadr is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave him this. So while we are in Laylatul Qadr, we have to know who is the source of Laylatul Qadr. You know, this in Ramadan, all the doors of paradise opens. Al-Jannah inviting all of us. Come to me. Mm-hmm. Come to the highest ranking in me. Yeah. Don't let yourself in the low place in paradise, because but everything is great. But no, gain more and more. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that Allah gave him jawami al-kalim. That means in few words, he will do a lot of meanings. But there is something called jawami al-a'mal. The gathering of what? Of actions. Small actions will give you a lot. So praying to rak'ah in this night, or doing the qiyam of this night, will give you more than 80 years of worship. One night. What is the best action to do in this night? To get the maximum. You know, there is an incident where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, went to Fajr, and he saw that one of his family, she is doing dhikr. He came back after duha, she's doing dhikr. He said, look, I did one dua or one dhikr that's higher than everything you did. I did subhanallah wa hamdihi, adada khalqihi, warada nafsihi, wazinata arshihi, wadada kalimatihi. Allah wanted to teach her and teach all of us that you made the thing that will give you a lot. Because our lifespan is very short. It's not like the previous nations where 1,000 years. This ummah, the Rasulullah, this Amar ummati between 60 and 70. The lifespan of my ummah is between 60 to 70. Very rare to be more than that. So one of the best things to give you to get in this 10 days is to go to that source who gave us this late father, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we do salawat on Rasulullah sallam, definitely you read Quran, you do night prayer, but Rasulullah sallam told us, أَنَا حَظُّكُمْ مِنَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. I am your share, I am your luck, I'm your portion of from prophets. So we need to increase our hadd, we need to increase our share. And we increase it by having ourselves be mentioned by the tongue of Rasulullah sallam. So he will mention us, because he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if you do salawat on me, Allah will give me my life back, I'll be hay, so give you back salah on you and salam on you. And Allah told him, salli alayhim fa inna salataka sakarun lahum. Do salah on them, because your salat is tranquility on them. And Rasulullah told us that if you do one salah, Allah will do 10 of you, on you. 10 from Allah, and the angel will do the same thing. Because inna Allah wa laikati yasalluna alayhi. What will happen in this case? Allah told the Quran, هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته. Allah and the angel do salah on you. Why? What's the result of this? ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور. To take you away from darkness, put you in light. So when we get this spiritual breeze that's happening this night, and we put it in it, our salah on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I want my name to be mentioned in front of Rasulullah, because the angel, one angel will take, say, Ya Rasulullah, so-and-so, the son of so-and-so, give you salam. I want my name to be present in front of Rasulullah salam every second in this night. Whenever I'm not doing prayer or Quran, I will do salat Rasulullah salam, because I want to get a maximum of this night. Imagine if you gathered the high spiritual gain you get in Ramadan, the high spiritual gain you get in the last 10 nights, and the high spiritual gain you get in the odd nights, and in being fasting and do a qiyam, and then with what? With the salat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then this will be presented, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, your action being presented to me. تعرض أعمالكم علي. He said, you present to me. Imagine that our action being presented to Rasulullah SAW. He's saying that salah on him. And he said, if I find something good, I'll do hamd on your behalf. So the salawat that we're doing, we're wrapped with the hamd of Rasulullah SAW. And they're going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will receive the best of action, which is the salah of Rasulullah SAW. Because this salah is a dua is never, always accepted, regardless of the status. That's the only dua that never been rejected. So being wrapped with the hamd, going to Allah, Allah will put a lot of khair in it. And this action, the one we are doing on the Day of Judgment, when we come and look at it and see it, we say, whose prophet is this action? They say, no, this is your action. It's covered, wrapped with the hamd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then added with the khair, being grown with the khair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be presented to you now. And then at that moment, say, Alhamdulillah, that Allah made us to do this, and that Allah made us to, you know, get the maximum of these 10 nights, inshallah. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Wa abdur salawat wa tabasim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik wa an'am wa azim wa karim ala Sayyidina wa habibina wa tabibina wa shafi'ina wa qaidina wa qurrat ayunina Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazallah khair Sayyidi Qari Umar. He selected day for us with this night of the inshallah Laylatul Qadr, this night of a special night. He gave us the Surah Ar-Rahman. Now, what's special about the Surah Ar-Rahman? Allah Azza wa Jal, the first verse that revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Sayyidina Jibreel came to him and said, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read by the name of Allah, the one who created. What's that name? And later on, we'll figure out that the name is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in the Quran the only surah that starts with the name of Allah. There's only one, which is ar-Rahman. It's only this surah that is said ar-Rahman. Allama al-Quran. Khalaqa al-insan. Allama al-bayan. So Allah selected for us to tell us that He is the one that created everything through His rahmah. And He told us, Rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. My mercy super exceed my anger. So if they're wrestling, the mercy and the anger, the winner is the mercy. And we are lucky because of this. And in another hadith said, Rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. That my mercy encompasses everything. And everything except Allah is shay. So the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover everything. Now, how do we implement this? This rahmah, how do you implement this? How this rahmah be implemented? You know, this verse of Rahman, when the kuffar, they said, Allah told them in the Quran, or some told them, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اسْجُدُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ. Do sajda al-Rahman. قَالُوا وَمَا الرَّحْمَنِ. We don't know who's Rahman. And then the surah came, Ar-Rahman عَلَّمُ الْقُرْآنِ. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. Allah created Allah first taught the Quran and taught us how to talk. It's a bayan. How to say what we want to say. How do we express ourselves? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم one day somebody recited the Rahman in front of him, and he said, "Why I see all the jinn better than you?" They said, "What's that, Ya Rasulullah?" He said, "Whenever they hear فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ," which is the meaning, which of the blessing of Allah you deny, they will say in each time, it's been mentioned 31 times, each time they say وَلَا بَأَيِّ آلَاءِ مِنْ رَبِّنَا نُكَذِّبَ, or none of the blessing of Allah we deny, we say Alhamdulillah. So he said, don't let the jinn be better than you. Because Allah in the Quran is interacting with you. Now, there is a small secret here. I want to everybody to get this secret. And this is from the Arifin. They say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he told us, huwa rahma lil alameen. His rahma, so the implementation of Ar-Rahman, he sent rahma lil alameen. Now we can say in our dua, we ask Allah for the rahmah for the ummah. We ask Allah, for example, the hadith said, if you ask Allah for maghfira, if you say Rabbi ghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat, oh Allah forgive mu'minin and mu'minat, you will get for every believer, you get hasana, because you ask for everybody, you know. But you want something dua that will cover everything. Rasulullah says, rahma lil alameen. What's the alameen? Alameen is anything but Allah. So all creation is alameen. And Rasulullah is rahma lil alameen. So when you say, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, when you say salawat Rasulullah, you are increasing this rahma. You're asking Allah to increase the rahma, because he rahma lil alameen, to put barakah in this rahma. So you are making dua not only for the human being, not only for the creation, not only for the animals, for the whole alameen, the seven heavens, all the angels. So Salah Rasulullah is actually, you are asking Allah, and Allah is saying, "Ad'uni asib lakum." And the scholar, they say the dua is never been rejected, is the Salah Rasulullah. That's why Allah told us, "Laqad ja'akum rasulun min anfusikum, azizun 'alayhi ma 'anittum, harisun 'alaykum bil mu'minina ra'ufur rahim." We send amongst you, from you, a prophet who really is hard on him what you're suffering. It's he is cares a lot about you, harisun 'alaykum, better than your parents, and he has a rahma and ra'fa on you. He is, they say, his rahma is better than our parents. So when you say Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, then we recognize this and we ask Allah, Ya Allah, increase your Habib, increase your Rahma, increase your Rahma. That's why Sayyidina Qadir Rahman today, he said Ar-Rahman. He read this amazing verse. Now, one of the secrets, as I said, also from the Arifin, they said in this last 10 days, don't depend on your deeds. Depend on his rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look, if we think, you know, I'm doing qiyam, I'm doing siyam, I'm doing charity, I'm doing this and this, I'm depending on my deeds. But if I depend on the wider scale, which is the rahmah of Allah, then everything I want, I will get. Because the secret of this 10 days, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves his creation. And his love in this 10 days increases a lot. And his rahmah increases a lot. So if you ask him anything you wish, anything, definitely ask something for which good, but ask something that's bad, and ask something for big. Ask the murafaqat al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be with his companion, with him all the time. Okay? And also, have a good opinion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have a good opinion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you ask for, you have no doubt of this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Rasulullah told us, I'm at the good opinion of me. If you think that I'll give you whatever you ask me, I'll give you. If you think that I'll give you the highest position in paradise, I'll give it to you. Just have a good opinion. Husnul dhan, you know. And then the lastly, inshallah, try to, in these 10 days and these 10 nights, call Allah with all his names that you know. So we ask Allah, Ya Hannan, Ya Mannan, Ya Rahman, Ya Ra'uf, Ya Habibi. Ask Allah with all the names of Allah, Ya Wadud. You know, go with the 100 names and ask Allah with each one. Because once you ask Allah, Allah is waiting for you, waiting for all of us. This is special in Ramadan, especially these last 10 days. And that will make, you know, every night is like Laylatul Qadr when you do this. Ask Allah, Ya Allah, give me the reward of every night. Give me the reward. Die higher than Laylatul Qadr. Allah will give it to you. Allah is generous, but Allah wanted to see that this is us. We are asking him. We're coming to him. We need from him. We are not depending on our deeds. We're not depending on, you know, I'm good now. I'm really good. I'm not watching this. I'm not seeing this. I'm not, you know, I'm just, all my time is for Allah. It's good what you are doing, definitely. Rasulullah used to be in the last 10 days, just get in the i'tikaf, doing nothing from dunya at all. Nothing. Now, for us, a lot of us, we have to work and so on. But once you get between you, yourself, like have a special time between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Him with His names. Just sit, ask Allah. Ya Rahman, Ya Wadud, Ya Kareem. Ask Allah. And make sure 100% that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no doubt, will give you. And He will give you maybe better what you ask. Have no doubt in this. He will take away from you all the bad things rather than give you the small thing that you ask for. And do salawat al Rasulullah because He is Rahmal al-Alameen. Once you do salawat al Rasulullah, you are asking Allah to increase that rahmah that covered the whole Alameen, and you get reward for all the Alameen because you are asking Allah for that. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.